Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In the previous video, we have completed all the category APIs of Cafe Management System project. If you have not seen that video, just go to description and check out the link. In this video, we are going to work on product APIs. So let us start with that. So first we have to create the table. So open MS SQL and here we have to click on new query and here we have to write the query to create the table. So I'm going to write here create table and it should be product and first that will be ID. So ID should be int type and identity 1, 1 and it should be primary key and after that name varchar and 255 after that category ID integer after that description varchar 255 price integer status varchar 20 then we have to execute this query so click on execute you can see compile successfully if I refresh this one you are able to see the table okay so I think it has been created on some different so just need to okay it has been created on master so select whatever the database you want to execute it and now if I execute it and refresh it now the table will be visible over here so you can see product is over here so now go to the VS over here and now we have to go to the models and cafe entities click on it and here we have to right click on this one and here we have to write update models from database click on it and then we have to extend this to and click on product and click on finish so it will get the like table and display here just wait for a few seconds so here you can see and after that click outside of this one and save this so it will take few seconds to save this one now we have to go to the controller folder and here we have to create a new file click on add controller and we have to click on web API click on this one click on add and here we have to change the product controller click on add and you can see a file has been creating so you can see file has been created now inside this one first we need to set the route prefix so I'm going to write here route prefix and API slash product and inside this one we have to write cafe entities db is equals to new cafe entities okay we also need to import so this will we are going to import it from models so this one we just need to click you can see this one added over here and after that we'll write response is equals to new response and after that we have to write the code for to add new product so HTTP post method and route add new product and here we have to write custom authentication filter public HTTP response message add new product and here we have to write from body product and here we have to write try catch block so try catch exception ex return request dot create response and http status code dot internal server error ex put semicolon, and inside tribe log we have to write where token request dot headers dot get values, and here we have to write authorization dot first, then we get token claims, and token claim is equals to token manager dot validate token, and we will pass the token over here, and if token claims dot rule is not equals to admin, in that case we have to return request dot create response, and here the HTTP status code dot unauthorized semicolon, and product dot status is equals to true. Okay, so this status will be not coming from the UI, so we are going to set some values status over here. So the status we are setting it, and db dot product dot add, and here whatever the object we are getting from the UI we are going to just add in our database, and db dot save changes, and once it gets saved then we are going to response with the message. The message will be product added successfully and return request dot create response and HTTP status code dot okay, and here we have to just return response and save this. Now let's just start this application, and let's test this API first. So here we have to go at this place. Here we are just going to change this one is to new product, and we are also going to change this one as a product, and here in the body we have to add multiple fields. So name will be there, so I'm going to write here t name, let's write black tea, and after for that we also need to pass the category ID. So for the T, the category ID will be 1, and after that we have to pass the description or price. So price 1, 2, 3, and description, and here we have to just like black T description. And now we have to get the token, so I'm going to go into body and I'm going to hit this API, and we got the token as it has been old, the token has been expired. So authentication, I'm going to paste that token and going to hit this API. You can see product added successfully. So let's go to the database and let me try to execute this one, select. And here you can see the name, you can see the category ID, you can see the description, you can see the price, and you can see the status. All the fields is filled up. So it means that our add new product API is working as expected. So let me stop this one. And now let's write the code to get all the product API, okay? So let us start that. Now here we have to write HTTP get method and route, and the route will be get all product and custom authentication filter. Let me scroll this one, and public HTTP response, HTTP response, and here we have to just message, right, and get all product, and inside this one we write try catch block, and here we have to just write exception ex, and just need to return the error. So return request dot create response and HTTP status code dot internal server error and ex, and here in the try block we have to write where result is equals to from product, not products, products in. Okay, so if I select this one, if we get, okay, it's already get fixed. So products in db dot products, this one, and then we are going to join the category in db dot categories, and on products dot category id equals, we are going to match with the category ids with the category table, and if it is match, then we are going to select that, then select new and brackets, and here we write products dot id product dot name product dot description products dot price and products dot status, and then we have to select the category. So category id, we are creating a variable, and here we have to pass the category dot id, and here we have to write category name is equals to category dot name, this one. Save this, put semicolon at the end of this one, and after that we have to just return request dot create response and HTTP status code dot OK, and then we have to return the result and put semicolon, and our apget all product API is ready. So basically we are doing the join over here, we are matching the category ID with the category ID table having primary key which has been stored, and then we are selecting all these values. So category ID we are getting from the category table, and name we are also getting over here. Okay, so after this API, the next API will be to get product by category. So let's write the code for that one also. So outside of this one, so it will be also the HTTP get method and route, and here we write get, let me scroll this one, get product by category slash id, and here custom authentication filter, and public HTTP response message, and get product by category int id we are expecting, and here we have to write try catch, and here we have to write exception Okay, it's automatically. So here we have to write exception ex, and here we have to write return request dot create response http status code dot internal server error ex, and var result is equals to db dot products dot fail x, and x dot category id. We are going to search by category id. If it is matched with the id, and we also need to change the status. If a status is true, then only we are going to return all the that particular product. So here we write x new and x dot id comma x dot name dot to list we need to return as a list. We put semicolon and return request dot create response http status code dot ok result, put semicolon, save this. So you can see error has been removed. So what we are doing over here, so we will get category ID. So on the basis of category ID, we are going to search in our database, and we also are checking that the status of that particular product which exists with having category ID, this one should status true, then only we are going to return ID as well as name of that particular product. So that's what we are doing over here. And now we have to write the one more API to get product by ID. So we just want all the details related to any product with their ID. So for that we have to write the code. So get product and route, and here we have to change to get product by ID slash ID and custom authentication filter public HTTP response message get product by ID int ID and try, and here we write product obj object which we are going to search in our database. So product dot find, and in this we just need to pass the ID and return request dot create response and http status code dot ok, and then we have to just pass the product obj and save this. And the catch block we are going to return exception ex, and here we have to just return request dot create response and http status code dot internal server error and ex and save this. So our three APIs, get all product, get product category, or get product by ID. So these three APIs we have to test it now. So for that, let's go over here. So before that, let's wait for servers to up and running, and let's go to the git. Let me close this one, don't save. First we are going to check the git all product API. So I'm going to paste it over here, change this one to product, and let me update the token over here, authentication, just change this one, try to hit the API. Okay, so it's our server is up and running, and here you can see ID 1, name black tea, you can see the description, you can see the price, and you can see the status, and you can see the category ID and category name. So it means that it's working as expected. Let me add one more item over here in the category. So if I go to the body, I'm going to change it to 2, and I'm going to write here name, and here I'm going to write 100, and I'm going to write a test. I'm going to hit the API and product added successfully. If I hit again this API, so it's time, you can see we are getting 2 records. So it means that it's working fine. Now let's change this API so that our next API will be get product by category. So if I select write this one and slash, I'm going to write a 1 and I'm going to hit the API. You can see we are getting only 1 because we are searching by category ID. So category ID 1 having only 1 product. Okay. And if I want to add one more product, let's write here 1, 1, and 1. And if I hit this one, and here if we pass category ID 2, it should return 2 record. Here you can see it's returning the 2 record. So it means that get product by category is also working as expected. So now let's time to check the get product by ID. So I'm going to write here this one. I'm going to hit the API. You can see we are getting this one values. If I write 1, we are getting the value as expected. So it means that our all 3 APIs related to get has been is working as expected. So now it's time to write the code to update the product API. So I'm going to write here outside of this one and HTTP post method, this one route, and here we have to write update product and custom authentication filter and public HTTP response message and update product, and here we have to write from body and product, and let me scroll this one and try. And the initially we have to write the code to restrict that only admin can copy hit this API. So we have to just get in add new product, we have to write this line of the code. So just copy paste this one and paste it over here, and we also need to add the catch block over here. So exception EX, and it should return request create response and HTTP status code dot internal server error, and outside of this one you have to write product obj and db dot products dot find and product dot id. So whatever the ID we will get, we are going to search on the basis of that. If product obj is equals to null, so it means that product ID has been sent by the user does not exist. So response message is equals to product ID does not found, this error we are going to return. Okay, we also need to put a semicolon at the end and return request dot create response HTTP status code dot okay and response, whatever the response we get, we have to just return that one. And here we write product. If object is not null, in that case, whatever the we getting from this one object from UI, we are going to just store that over here. So product obj dot category ID is equals to product dot category ID and product obj dot description is equals to product dot description and product obj dot price is equals to product dot price, and after the db dot entry and product obj dot state is equals to system, and modified this one, and db dot save changes response dot message product updated successfully return request dot create response and http status code dot ok response. So our update product API is ready. So now let's test it out. Let me start the application. Let me change over here, so it should be update. So I'm going to copy this one for now, paste it over here. I'm going to change this one to post, remove this one, and here we have to just copy paste this one, update product, and paste over here. Authentication, I need token, so I'm going to copy the token, here token, paste it over here. In the body we also need to pass some values, so I'm just going to copy paste the same body, so raw JSON, paste it over here. Let me drag this one little bit. So category ID here we have to writing 2, and description will be there, name will be there, price will be there, and we have to just write, I pass one, that will be ID. So I'm going to write here ID, and let's go to the database and let's execute this one. So you can see this one, and here you can see the ID, right? So I'm going to write a 3. So I just want to update the ID, which is 3. So I'm going to write a 3. And for the price, okay, so I just want to update this one, and I'm going to write here I'm just going to write test and hit the API. So you can see product updated successfully. If I go over here, if I execute, you can see the name has been changed to 3. So let's change this one also. Let's change the category to 1. Let's change the price to 111, and let's change this one to only test description, and let's hit this API. So if I go over database and if I execute this, you can see all the fields has been changed. So it means that our update product API is working as expected. Let's go to the VS. Let's stop this one. And now we have to write the code to update the product. So let's write that also. So it will be HTTP post method and route. And here we write delete product ID custom authentication filter public HTTP response message product int ID and try catch exception ex return request dot create response and HTTP status code dot internal server error and ex and here in the try block we have to write the same code to restrict this API to get hit by other users. Just copy paste this line of the code and paste it over here, and then we have to write product and product obj equals db dot product dot find, and we have to just pass the ID. And if product obj is equals to null, it means that product does not exist in our database. So response dot message and product ID does not found, this error, and return dot request dot create response and HTTP status code dot OK and response. And after that, if condition, if product exists, so we have to just call the remove and we have to just pass the product obj and db.save changes and response message and product deleted successfully, and put semicolon and return request dot create response and HTTP status code dot OK and response, and put save this one. After this one, we have to just check this API. So let me start this one, let me run this one, let me copy this one, and we have to hit this API. So we have created this as a HTTP post. So I'm going to use this one, and here we have to just change this one and slash and whatever the ID. So I'm going to delete ID 3 and just wait for a few seconds to start. Yeah, our backend is up and running. So I'm going to hit this one API. Product deleted successfully. If I go to the database, if I try to execute this one, you can see that product does not exist. It means that our API is working as expected. Now if I try to delete the same again, so you can see product ID does not found. We are getting this message as a return. Okay, so now we have to write one more API, and this will be our last API for this product. Okay, so that API to update the product status. So here outside of this one, here we have to write HTTP post and route and update product status and custom authentication filter public. Let me scroll this one. Public HTTP response message and update product dot status and from body product this one try catch block and return. Okay, so here we also need to write exception ex and return, and here we write request dot create response and HTTP status code dot internal server error and ex. And in try block, first we need to write the restrictions for the API. So I'm just going to copy paste this line of the code and paste it over here. And after that, we have to write product obj is equals to db dot product products. Then we have to find by product dot id, and if product id product obj is equals to null, then return with the message that response the message that product id does not found. So product id does not found with this message, and return return request dot create response and HTTP status code dot OK and response, and here we write to check product dot status is equals to product dot status, this one, and db dot entry, and here we write product obj dot state and system modified, this one, and db dot save changes, and response dot message product status updated successfully, and return request dot create response and HTTP status code dot OK and response and save this. Now let's start this application, and here we have to just copy this one, update status, this one, and this is a post method, so I'm going to change this one as a, and here we have to just delete this part, and in this we just need to pass the ID and whatever the status, so just delete these values, these are not used, so I'm going to write here. So status, I'm going to pass it here false, try to hit the API, if it's up and running, yeah it's up and running, so I'm trying to hit this one. Okay, product ID does not found. Okay, so in the database, okay, product ID 3 does not exist, so I'm going to change this to 2 and try to hit the API. You can see product status updated successfully. If I execute this one, it should show the false. If now if we try to get the API, if I go over here, get product, okay, so if I now try to hit this API, let me scroll this one, get product by category, so if we try to hit this API now, here I'm going to pass the category 2, so it should not return any product, because our status is set to the false and we are trying to get the, if I set to the true and if I try to get it, let's hit this API first, hit this one, and then we have to check for the get, hit this one, you can see we are getting the data. Okay, so it means that our status change is working as expected. So this is all APIs related to product page or controller. I hope you guys like this video, so please hit like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.